great privilege. I got to play football for a long time. I got to play from middle school, I got to play high school, I got to play college, and I got to play professional football for a number of years. Every successful team that I was on had one common characteristic. Had a whole bunch of guys that were willing to put the team above themselves. That they would do literally whatever it took to help their team win football games. And in the time I've been coaching, there's nobody that exemplifies this more than Cian Marderos. Last year as a junior, Cian's one of the best athletes that's ever rolled through our program. Last year, shows up, he's gonna play tight end, he's gonna play fullback, you know, all of this stuff, and all of a sudden, discovered that we have not enough linemen to take the field and play football. And so we had to go to Cian and say, hey buddy, guess what? You're 66, on your playing guard. And I know that was a really, really bitter pill for him to swallow because he's fast. You've seen the highlights. He can run, he can catch, he can do all of this stuff. But then he swallowed his pride, jumped in there, and became an absolutely dominant offensive guard for us last year. This year, you know, as a staff, it's kind of a unique thing when literally every coach on the staff is fighting for one guy. Except for God.
We didn't want him to play quarterback.
But every other position, Corbin wanted him to play offensive line still. I was coaching tight ends. I wanted him to play tight end. Dan wants him to play running back, fullback. He just really a unique guy. He just said, hey, yeah, wherever you want me, that's where I'll play. That's what I'll do. And again, as I said about Ben, you know, this guy's going to go out and play some college football somewhere. It makes it so darn easy to tell that story to a college football coach. If you want a guy of the highest character in your program, sign this guy up because he's going to be a good girl.